folks, it's Mitch Boyle, Triple Double Sports Cards, and I thought we'd do something slightly different. Of course, we're on the vein now where instead of waiting for all the vintage cards to come back in, and of course we specialize in primarily basketball, I thought I'd get up with the program and contemporize, as I've been saying, and my son said, by the way, when people do keyword search for superstars like LeBron James, Damian Lillard, and Chris Paul, which you're about to see, not only that, but say John Morant and Zion Williamson, I'm going to have that inventory. Of course, I'll have a lot more vintage. But today I thought I'd kind of take a look at what's happening with the market with a few cards, just to show you why I'm doing a little more buying right now. And timing is good because I'm having to wait forever for my vintage cards over, I don't know, somewhere between 800, 900 cards to come back, including wax packs, the whole deal. But as you guys know, that might take till my first round might not come back until maybe November, December at the earliest, which I sent them out back in, I want to say, was that April or May? Anyway, so let's share the screen. And I'll what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you three cards and what I bought them at. And then I'm going to jump over to the interweb and take a look at what these cards are were going for, and you'll see what I bought them for. But these are cards that are not called modern in the Beckett world, where they charge you $15 a card. These would be $12 a card, but these are all gem mint 10. Damian Lillard, rookie LeBron James from 2012. I love these Panini Brilliance. They're really cool, with the silver embossing at the bottom. And then this is the Chris Paul rookie card. I don't know if it's the most important one. I'm sure it's not, because it's upper deck. But again, it's a gem mint 10. So what I thought I'd do is I'm going to do that. And then let's go dig in and let's find out what these cards are currently going for. So as an example, here's the Damian Lillard card, and this was purchased on August 16th and went for $226 in an auction. Now, this is how much I think the market has deflated. I bought it, as you can see, for $145, and I bought it, whatever that was, 5-6 days ago. So there's one example. Now, let's take a look at this Chris Paul card. I don't know. I think there's a way to take the selling number and pop it into a program, which actually I do have. But as I recall, I think this card went for $155. So as an example, and then you have a Beckett that went for on August the 29th, which is a 9.5, which obviously is lower value regardless. So here are the two cards I bought. I bought two of them the other day on October the 28th. And so the prices have, is that a drop of 50%? Yeah, that's a drop of 50% or something like that. Bought them basically for $99, and when you buy two, of course, I only paid the $5 shipping. So in any event, certainly a revision in the market. And then I'll look at this particular card. You saw the LeBron James card and the Brilliance card. So here's a recent example. Somebody bought this card on August the 8th for $180. It was an auction, and at that time it was a population 101, so I'm sure that's part of the reason. And then we go down here a little bit further, and you'll see somebody bought one. I'm going to guess that went for in the $115 range or something like that. But somebody a couple days before that did it on a buy now for $130. And then I bought it for $96. So we went from 180 plus down to $100. So that's a huge, huge reduction. And so I don't know if the market's going to continue to slip, but we'll have to see. So now let's go back and let's go to sharing here, because what I want to do is I'm going to pop these guys out and I'll show you some other what I would call value propositions that are going on right now. Sharing the screen now so you can see some other recent purchases. And in this particular case, this Kevin Durant from 2016, which is the more modern era where you charged $15 just to get it graded from PSA, and way more from Beckett. I want to say if you're grading 50 cards, it's going to still cost you $30. So in any event, this card I bought, including shipping, for $26. I'm going to guess that card was not going out inexpensively. Here's a James Harden card. Again, 2017 All-Stars. And I think I got this card, including shipping, for $18. This card, which I found really interesting. This is a 2016, so quote-unquote, in the eyes of our friends at PSA. I'm going to move that just a little bit. This is a Panini Excalibur jousting, if you will. Gem Mint 10, and you saw the last three cards were all Gem Mint 10s. The Court Kings for Kevin Durant, and then the James Harden Panini, which was the All-Stars. That was a Gem Mint 10. This is a Gem Mint 10 too. All in, and I'll bet you it's really hard to find any Stephen Curry that has been graded at a Gem Mint 10 from PSA at $19, but that's what I bought this for. So I thought that was interesting. You know, I got this card just because I like the player a lot. It does fit with the vintage mode, if you will. It came out in 2017. I'll put it down here. Maybe I'll just do a little zoom ski if I can. A little bit more, maybe. There we go. Mitch Richmond. Hall Kings. I would imagine that means he's in their Hall of Fame. Has he made the Hall of Fame in the NBA yet? I don't know. But this was a Gem Mint 10. And again, I got this for like $12. And as you know, some of the promotions I'm going to be doing will include the usage of the name of our company, Triple Double. So if you buy three cards at a certain price, I'm going to give you a double or a 10. So I'm trying to acquire quite a few of these. And you know what? Okay, maybe not the most memorable player of all time, but probably the most memorable King, at least at this point. Mitch Richmond played for the Lakers as well. So anyway, kind of a feeling on this relatively short video about what's going on with the industry, still plugging away on getting a lot of new cards. Excited about these opportunities and the value that's out there. I don't know if this is going to continue or even drop further. And you know what we'll do? We'll continue to monitor this because I'm going to be buying a batch of contemporary cards off and on over the next month or so until I start seeing the PSA and Beckett stuff roll in. So anyway, thank you so much for watching today. And by the way, make sure you smash, is that right? Yeah, that's what my son said to tell you. Smash the subscribe, give me a like, and most of all, what I want are comments and suggestions and ideas and questions. For you to let us know what's on your mind. So again, thanks so much for watching. It's Mitch Boyle, Triple Double Sports Cards.